Hello, we're here with TBN Sports. Dial 617 Talk Sports to call. I'm your host, Tyler Goh, alongside Nate Fell
and Ben Walsh.
Today, our first topic is the blockbuster trade that sent Kawhi for DeMar DeRozan. All right, any thoughts, guys?
Well, I personally think I couldn't care less about this trade. It's a pretty much a star for a star. They're almost on the same level. Kawhi's a bit better. I feel like teams was almost just like an evener. They just changed good players. It's not going to have too big of a difference on each team. At the most, 3-win difference. I really don't think it's that big of an impact. I don't feel like it's that big of a trade.
I don't think the Spurs are going anywhere with this, but potentially, because of all the talent joining the West, there could be some potential move of a player wanting to get out of the West, moving into the East and going to the Raptors, making a team of Kyle Lowry, Kawhi Leonard, and someone else, that another star that wants to join that core and make a Eastern Conference team that would be the best in the East. And I feel like that is what could potentially happen from this. Maybe Kawhi has some connections or
others. That's a good point.
Well, I mean, we all know, it's not 100% sure, but Kawhi is most likely a one-year rental.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, the Spurs, I think, still have DeRozan for about 3 years, right? So the Raptors could contend immediately, while the Spurs may have to work out some, like, you know, the rebuild, and it's just Lonnie Walker and DeMar DeRozan. Well, we could see what happens.
DeMar DeRozan.
I have also an add-on to your thing. How you said how he's almost guaranteed a one-year rental. That's what people thought of Paul George. He said he wanted to go to the Lakers.
That's a good point.
And then he stayed and he got re-signed.
You never really know. There's still a whole year left for him to change his mind. And maybe he likes it in Toronto and he wants to stay there, especially if they can bring in another star to make this team the best.
Well, it depends what's going to happen with the coaching. Like, you know, you saw Dwayne Casey. If they stayed with Dwayne Casey.
I personally think that was a dumb move to get rid of Dwayne Casey.
If he was coaching.
Maybe they can bring in a good coach. But, like, I mean, Dwayne Casey wasn't working out. They don't want to just have the best regular season record and then get eliminated in the second round. Is that what you would want if you were, like, an NBA franchise?
No, of course not.
Like, they need someone who can do something in the playoffs. They need a coach that can lead them to the NBA Finals, and I don't think Dwayne Casey is the one for that. So, and the only reason he won Coach of the Year is because it's based on regular season. So.
And we have a caller. His name is Grover Zale from Las Vegas.
Hey guys, you should see the slot machines out here today. They're on fire. Let me ask you this. If Kawhi Leonard doesn't re-sign in Toronto, which I think is pretty unlikely, where do you think he'll end up?
I think he'll end up in the Lakers.
He's publicly stated that he likes the Clippers more than the Lakers, and I think he wants his own team more than to share with LeBron.
What he could do is he could sign like a 2-year deal with the Lakers, try to hopefully contend for a title in 1 year, and then or he could just go straight to the Clippers and hope that they rebuild.
I think the Clippers have a great future already, and they're like one of the deepest teams in the league. I mean, they got Jerome Robinson and Shai Gilgeous. What?
So now we're going to talk about Manny Machado and his trade to the Los Angeles Dodgers. Well, personally, I'm happy for Machado. The Orioles are looking like the worst team ever. They're 42.5 games behind the Red Sox in the AL East. He had to get out of there. He was the only good hitter on that team. He's like almost escaping from them. That's a good move on his part.
Well, the thing for Machado is the Orioles really needed, like, they knew they weren't going to get Machado back. So obviously they were going to try to get something for him while they could before they don't get anything, but they have to get rid of it.
I feel like a scenario like this makes more sense in the NBA, where you would be really bad, but you would trade your best player to make you even worse, because tanking's
like
not really...
Like DeMarcus Cousins almost.
Yeah, tanking hasn't became like a trend, if you want to say, in the MLB yet, just because of how the draft works and how you don't get most players. The draft isn't really, it's not like an assuring thing where you're going to get a good player if you get a high pick.
It works out because Machado, like...
And Machado's been the only good hitter on that team, and if I were Machado, I would not want to be on a team that has 28 wins after the All-Star break.
In the last few
years, that good of a player.
In the last few, it works out for the Orioles because they do get something back instead of getting nothing.
Oh, some young prospects. Also for the Dodgers.
Also for the Dodgers, because it's their immediate contention.
Okay, so about Machado, how saying he's only hitter. Late in the last few years, they had Nick Markakis, and Nelson Cruz, and Chris Davis. But now all of them left except for Chris Davis. But he's like, he can't even hit. He's having historically the worst season in MLB history. He's hitting horribly.
So keep in mind that this is also great for the Dodgers, already leading their division. So I think that with this deal, this will put the Dodgers in the playoffs, and so Thank you for watching. We're TBN Sports. I'm Tyler.
I'm Nate.
No, we ended.
And goodbye.